Welcome to another iScaf tutorial. In this iScaf video, we will show you a feature that allows you to separate your material lists into different stages and levels. If we look at the main setup, we see that we have a 40-foot high scaffold. We have two sets of side brackets at two different levels, and we have 3 foot six wide scaffold. We click OK on that, and as you can see, we have built 3 8-foot bays and 3 7-foot bays with labels showing that they are 40 foot high and 3 foot six wide. So let's build this to 3D, and then we can generate the material list for the drawing. Before we do that, let's use the iScaf drop-down menu. Select Utilities, then select Display Scaffold Levels. This shows the levels that have been assigned as a default for this particular drawing. So level 1 goes from 0 to 3 foot, and level 2 goes from 3 foot to 6 foot, and so on. So we generate our material list by clicking the quote button. Our material list appears, and as you can see, we have a total weight of about 1,000 pounds of scaffold. Now if we look at the planks and select our 7-foot steel planks, we can see that we have a total of 66 planks in the drawing. Then we can sort in levels. If we say sort level and select all and hit recalc, we actually see all the steel planks allocated for these different levels. Each level is also in those 3 foot increments as shown earlier. We can then look at individual levels by selecting sort level. Level 0 has nothing in it. Level 1, as shown earlier, goes from 0 to 3 foot. Here we can see the first level has the starter collar component and the screw jacks with a quantity of 14 showing. There are a few horizontal components there as well, but we have no boards in that first level because from 0 to 3 foot there are actually no boards. Looking at level 2, we click recalc and we see that we have some toe boards. And also 9 steel planks in this particular level among the other components. So level 3 has no components because none were assigned to it at the start. If we want to change the allocation of levels, we will need to create a section first. So to create a section or elevation, we click on the Create Section icon. Let's just select the default options there. Let's turn that off. We click OK. And we just window around two legs of the scaffold to build a section as per previous tutorials. So now that we have a section, we can actually allocate this to different levels. To do this, go to the menu, select iScaf, Build, Section, and we want to re-level our section, so simply follow the prompts at the bottom of the screen or where the cursor says Select Section. So we click on the actual section and then it says Select Objects. Now this is where the power comes into it. We can actually window any area where we want to allocate these stages and levels. In this particular example, we'll just show the levels. So we window all the scaffold. We could also just window a small section of the drawing if we wanted to allocate that, but in this case we're going to allocate the whole drawing. So we right click on that after selecting all of it and it shows our re-level section dialog box. As you can see, there's our 3 foot increment, which we can actually change. So if we double click on level 2, we might decide to just allocate the first level to be up to the first deck. So let's just go just above the first deck and click right there. So that height we selected, just by pointing to it, represents from 0 to 7'7". And then we go to level 3, which is basically representing level 2 of the scaffolding. Now this time we'll window just above the third deck. And then for the next level, we will go just above the fifth deck. And finally, the last level, we will just bring to the very top. So now we have level 1 going from 0 to roughly 7 foot, level 2 from 7 foot to 21 foot, level 3 from 21 to 35 foot, level 4 from 35 foot to 49 foot, and the rest will be ignored since we already reached the top of our scaffold. So if we click OK on this, the system will allocate the parts to those levels. Now when we go to generate the quote, exactly the same way as we did before, we can now select levels. And as we can see here again, we have our screw jacks and starter collars in the first level. But if we look at our steel planks, we have 9 steel planks in that very first level. Then if we press the recalc button, we will see that we have 18 steel planks because we selected 2 levels there for our next height. And as you can see, there are no screw jacks and starter collars. And then for level 3, hit recalc and we'll have 24 steel planks in that area. And finally, our last level shows 15 steel planks in that area. Basically, because that would include some of the planks needed for the side brackets or hop-ups, as shown at the very top of the scaffold. And level 5 is the end of the drawing. So any of these material lists, such as this material list, can be printed each level at a time just by clicking on the quote button or the PDF button. Or if we just say go back to none and we press recalc, we are back to our full material list. So that's how you allocate different levels in your scaffold drawing.